What should we drink?
It's pretty hot.
Let's drink beer.
Alright. Dos cervezas, please.
Dos grandes?
Yes, two big ones, please.
They look like white elephants.
Thank you. I've never seen one.
No, you wouldn't have.
Well, I might have. Just because you say I wouldn't have doesn't prove anything.
She just wrote something on the sign. What does it say?
Ernest del Toro. It's a drink.
Should we try?
Sure. Excuse me.
Cuatro reales.
We want two Ernest del Toros.
Con agua?
With water?
I don't know, it's good.
It's alright.
¿Los quieres con agua?
Yes, with water, please. Thank you. Alright, cheers.
Whew, it tastes like licorice.
That's the way with everything.
Yes, everything tastes like licorice. Especially all the things you've been reading for, like absinthe.
Oh, cut it out. You started it. I was being amused. I was having a fine time.
Well, let's try to have a fine time.
All right, I was trying. I said the mountains look like white elephants. Wasn't that bright?
That was bright.
I want to try this new drink. That's all we do, isn't it? Just look at things and try new drinks.
Yeah, I guess so.
The lofty hills. They don't really look like white elephants. I just meant the coloring of the skin through the trees.
Should we have another beer?
All right.
Hey, two please. Thank you. Thanks. All right, cheers.
Oh, the beer's nice and cool.
Yeah, it's lovely.
It's really an awful simple operation, Jake. It's not really an operation at all. I know you wouldn't mind it. It's not really anything. It's just, you know, to let the air in. Look, I'll go with you. I'll be with you all the time. They'll let the air out and everything will be fine.
Then what will we do afterwards?
We'll be fine afterwards. Just like we were before.
So, if I do it, then it'll be nice again. If I say things are like white elephants and you like it?
I'll love it. I love it now, but I just can't think about it. You know how I get when I worry.
If I do it, you won't ever worry?
I won't worry about that, because it's perfectly simple.
Then I'll do it, but because I don't care about me.
What do you mean?
I don't care about me.
Well, I care about you.
Oh yes, but I don't care about me, and I'll do it, and then everything will be fine, I guess.
Well, I want you to do it if you feel that way.
And we can have all this, and we can have everything, and every day we make it even more impossible.
What did you say?
I said we could have everything.
We can have everything.
No, we can't.
We can have the whole world.
No, we can't.
We can go everywhere.
No, we can't. It isn't ours anymore.
It is ours.
No, it isn't. And once they take it away, you'll never get it back.
But they haven't taken it away.
We'll wait and see.
Come back in the shade. You mustn't feel that way.
I don't feel any way. I just know things.
I don't want you to do anything that you don't want to do.
No, that isn't good for me. I know.
Okay, but you've got to realize.
I realize, but can you please stop talking?
You've got to realize that I don't want you to do it if you don't want to. I'm perfectly willing to go through with it if it means anything to you.
Doesn't it mean anything to you? We could get along.
Of course it does, but I don't want anybody but you. I don't want anyone else. And I know it's perfectly simple.
Yes, you know it's perfectly simple.
It's all right for you to say that, but I do know it.
Would you do something for me now?
I'd do anything for you.
Would you please, please, please stop talking?
But I don't want you to, and I don't care anything about it.
El tren llega en cinco minutos.
What does it say?
The train will be coming in 5 minutes. I'd rather take the bag to the other side of the station.
Alright, then come back and we'll finish the bag.
Sure. One Ernest del Toro, please.
Thank you.
Thanks. Do you feel better?
I feel fine. There's nothing wrong with me. I feel fine.
Hey man, scoot your side.
Oh Jesus Christ!
Hvad har du at sige til dit forsvar?
Ah!
Boel. Hvad så, bloggen? Vi skal til at filme scenen igen, fordi Gustav han fejlede.
Action.
Well, I don't want you to do it if you feel that way.
Ladies and gentlemen, he did it again! And we could have all this, and we could have everything, and every day we make it even more And we could have all this, and And we could have all this, and we could have everything, and every day we even make it...
Stop it, no.
I want you to do anything that you don't want to do.
Ikke lad mig nu.
So I'm sitting here with the director and the cameraman for the movie adaptation of Hills Like White Elephants, and I would like to ask you a few questions. How did you assert the dominance in the relationship in this movie?
So as for the American, we decided to film him in a worm's eye view to show that he was the dominant one in his relation, in their relationship, and the girl in a bird's eye view to make her kind of look small. And yeah, later on when she gets mad, she gets the worm's eye view to show that she is now controlling and not the other way around.
But then again, how there is a waiter that speaks Spanish. Yeah. Why is that?
Because they're in Spain. How did you work with your fantasy? Well, seeing as they were in Spanish, we decided to make the waiter Spanish because Spanish is kind of fucking funny, right?
Did you make some changes from the Hemingway story to your story?
Well, like a few dialogue changes where we put the emphasis on different words than what you would do when you were reading, and fewer people, because in the story they're on a train station, so you would expect there to be more people, but I decided that fewer people would put more focus on them and really emphasize that this was on their relationship.
From the Hemingway story to your adaptation of it, did you make some changes, like just small dialogue or big physical changes in your adaptation?
Yeah, we had some dialogue changes, more emphasis on certain words, like you would read it differently. But when you're sort of making a movie, it's not always the best way to just have the way you would read it, like in Harry Potter, they kind of fucked up a bit. So here we decided to put emphasis on other words to kind of put more pressure on certain situations. And we also decided to have less people around, so it was a lot easier to have focus on them and their relationship. And also, throughout reading the story, it all happens so fast, you don't get a lot of information. So we decided to take it a bit slower, so you can really feel the awkward environment around them. It's a lot more like dynamic. There's actually something happening between them instead of just reading and then suddenly you're somewhere else. And there's also a few dialogue lines that I had to cut out, and like the B curtain, just changed it to sign instead because that made more sense.
Okay. So in the movie, you kind of work with a couple of genres. Can you pinpoint some of it? Maybe the comedy, you talked about that at some point.
Well, there is a slight bit of comedy. It's not like completely in your face, other than some actor changes. I'm not gonna go into detail with that or how that happened. We also have some gag reels in the end because we're all some very great actors. We know what we're doing most of the time. Half the time we don't know what we're doing.
Okay. Now we have talked about the camera angles and perspectives and such, but can you go into more details about perhaps the cutting of the scenes and such, or?
Yeah, I can try. Well, we had some kind of long scenes to show the kind of awkwardness there's in this relationship. They don't really enjoy the company of each other. And we have in their dialogue, we have some smaller pieces put together of each in every line of the American and the girls lines. So yeah.
All right, thank you for your time. I will leave you be.
There's a faggot out there.
Oh god. Oh, it's been a first down. Well, rigtig meget. Du skal klippe jer.
Brasker.
Vi fejlede lidt meget.
Så længe det er dig, der arbejder, så er vi ligeglade. Hey, pas på fingeren. Jeg ved, hvor du bor. Nej.